I've got something to show you. Check this out. Welcome to my masks wall of fame. I've got everything from patterns to solids, from cloth to surgical. Any day, any time, I've got a mask for it. And yet, there's still so much I don't know about masks and what the best ways to be wearing them are. But I know exactly who to ask for some expert advice. Come on.
So there's really two good reasons why to wear masks. One is if you don't know you're infected, the one thing about COVID-19 is in the first couple of days, you can still transmit to other people before you get symptoms. And so wearing a mask essentially blocks you from being able to transmit the virus to others when you're feeling well, but you might be contagious to others. The other part, and the reason why we've always used masks in the hospital, is a really well-designed mask can also prevent you from getting COVID-19 if you're exposed to it from others.
Every day, I like to go outside for a walk around my neighborhood. Should I be wearing my mask outdoors?
So we know outdoors is a lower risk than indoors. It's not zero risk, but it's about 20 times lower risk than indoors. And if you're going to do something like skating or tobogganing where you're around a lot of people, it's a really good idea to wear a mask in that setting. But if you're just going for a walk, there's not a lot of other people around, or you're just with someone in your household, then it's not the end of the world to not wear a mask.
Most kids I see seem to be wearing these cloth masks. Mm-hmm. How safe are these cloth masks?
Yeah, so that they're good. The ones that we want to get are at least two layers and have a third layer for a filter. Now, making sure that these masks also fit is super important too.
Now, would you suggest layering masks? So let's say I have a medical mask, should I put another cloth mask on top?
In the grand scheme, you know, wearing a good quality, well-fitting mask is probably going to be much, much more of a bonus than adding another mask on top.
When it comes to these medical masks, can I reuse them?
We don't know how well they filter as time goes on, and so I really want to replace them probably every day if you're going to use them.
Recently around the internet, I've seen these clear window masks. Would you recommend wearing these masks?
You know, these are an alternative, particularly for folks with hearing impairment. For the average individual, you might want to stick to the cloth masks just because they're much more validated and certified for this type of use.
Earlier, you spoke about the importance of a good fit. How do I know if my mask fits well?
Yeah, so you want to make sure it goes over the bridge of your nose. You want to make sure it goes under the chin really nicely. You want a good seal on the sides, which I can see that you have. And then when you take a breath, you kind of want to feel it recirculating in front of your face.
Can you direct me on the best way to put on and remove a mask?
First things first, wash your hands before you touch your mask. You want to handle the mask by the loops more than anything else. Put the mask right back along your ears and just get that nose bridge part really settled. You want to pull under your chin and then wash your hands again, and you're good to go.
How can I avoid getting my glasses to fog while wearing a mask?
Yeah, there's a lot of different tricks. Making sure you have, yeah, exactly. Making sure you have a nice seal on the nose is good. And that's why you might have to try a few different brands. Some of the tricks, people sometimes use a little bit of tape along this part too, like just typical tape, just to, again, get that nice seal here.
Is it okay to have my mask under my chin like this?
No, you want to take it off. So when you have your mask on your chin, all of those germs are now sitting here under your chin, right?
Okay, how about this kind of earring type of look?
Same thing.
Okay.
You know? You don't want all the germs kind of dripping back and forth on your chin, right?
Okay, so I've seen some people kind of twist the loop and wear it like that. Would you recommend doing that?
If you feel like the mask is, you know, folding out on the sides, that can sometimes help tie it down to the sides a bit more.
Let's say I'm in a public space and I forget to bring my mask. Can you suggest any possible replacements?
You might want to use something like a handkerchief or a bandana to cover your face, although the evidence for those is not as good as a real well-fitting mask. And so you can use those maybe just as a bridge to, again, find a good mask in public.
What if I'm in a school setting? How about like a pencil case?
Same thing. Yeah, again, you want a good seal here. And it kind of looks kind of funny, I think, if you're going to be walking around with a pencil case on your face.
With all of this mask-wearing advice, I'm sure to be safe and trendy while wearing mine. That sounds like a win-win to me. Have you got more questions about COVID-19? Head over to cbckidsnews.ca for more information and stories like these. For CBC Kids News, I'm Anisha Latchman.